Hi friends, so today we are going to see tactile sensors. So now contents of this presentation are tactile sensors, then types of tactile sensors, then types are force or torque sensor, then dynamic sensor, then thermal sensor. These are the three types. Then advantages and applications of tactile sensors. So now let us see what is mean by tactile sensor. A tactile sensor is a device. It measures the coming information in response to the physical interaction with the environment. The sense of touch in human is generally modeled, that is cutaneous sense and the kinesthetic sense. Now what is mean by cutaneous sensation? So it receives sensory inputs from the receptors embedded in the skin. Senses like temperature, pressure, pain, these are the examples of this type of sensation. Next type is kinesthetic sensation. Kinesthetic sense receives sensory input from the receptors located with muscles, tendons and joints. The senses include body position, movement, equilibrium. These are the various things that are sensed by this kinesthetic sensation. Now cutaneous touch has the capability of detecting the stimuli resulting from the mechanical stimulation, pain and temperature. The kinesthetic touch receives sensor inputs from the receptors present inside the muscle, tendons and the joints. There are different types of tactile sensors which are given below: force or torque sensor, then dynamic sensor and thermal sensor. Now let us see one by one. Force or torque sensor. So they are used in combination with a tactile array to give the information for force control. These types of sensor can sense load anywhere, like the distal link of a manipulator and its constraints as a skin sensor. The skin sensor generally provides more accurate force measurement at higher bandwidths. If the manipulator link is definitely generally and the signal point contact is assumed, then the force or the torque sensors can give the information about the contact location of force and moments. It is called as intrinsic tactile sensing. Dynamic sensors are smaller accelerometers at the finger strips or at the skin of the robotic finger. The general function, like Pacinian corpuscles in humans, have equally large respective fields, thus one or two skin accelerometer are sufficient for entire finger. These sensors effectively detect and making and breaking of contact, the vibrations linked with the sliding over texture surface. So Pacinian corpuscle means it is a onion shaped structure of a non neurical tissue which is built around the nerve system. So that is used for sensing. So you can see the actual sensor here, the figure. Now, next type is dynamic sensor. Dynamic sensors are small accelerometers at the finger strips or at the skin of the robotic finger. So it is fitted at the robotic finger. The general function like Pacinian corpuscles in the human and have equally large respective fields, thus one or two skin accelerometers are sufficient for entire finger. These sensors effectively detect the making and breaking of contact, the vibrations linked with the sliding over textured surface. So now you can see here a dynamic sensor. Wireless dynamic sensor system. Altimeter, which records changes in the altitude for roller coaster physics. Then this is the 3-axis accelerometer. Then this is the onboard memory, retains data even after the unit is turned off. This is the hook, additional hook provided so that the device can be mounted. Then multiple mounting options also provided to the sensor, and this is the 4 sensors. A stress rate sensor is the second type of dynamic tactile sensor. If the finger tip is sliding at a speed of a few centimeter per second, overall small bumps or pits on the surface, the temporary changes in the skin become important. A piezoelectric polymer such as PVDF produces a change in response to damage that can be applied to produce a current which is directly proportional to the range of change. And last type of tactile sensor is thermal sensor. These are important to the human ability to identify the materials of objects made, but some are used in robotics as well. The thermal sensing involves detecting thermal gradients in the skin which are correspondent to both the temperature and the thermal conductivity of an object. Robotic thermal sensors are involved in the Peltier junctions in combination with the thermistors. This is the thermal sensor you can see. The tactile sensors are developed to provide tactile sensing abilities for tele operational manipulators and intelligent robots. The tactile sensors can identify a normal force applied to the tactile pixels for memorizing the force control and the tactile images and to generate object recognition. However, to obtain tactile images and normal forces, The information of tangential is critical for force control and slide prevention, which is memorizing the task success. Thus, three-dimensional tactile sensors are required. There are several three-dimensional tactile sensors developed by using piezo-resistive, capacitive, and optional sensing elements, and these tactile sensors are fabricated by the MEMS technology. The integrated sensing elements and the pre-processing circuits are for compactness, but these are too weak and easily broken for most of the applications. And for an example, the force range of a tactile sensor is only 0.01 Newton, and the other tactile sensors are not provided by the MES technologies. The below circuit diagram shows a tactile sensor circuit. So we just these are the three circuits. Advantages: the tactile sensor has no external components and cables. It is very compact unit, and verified tactile sensing technology is used for robotics applications. Robotics in computer hardware, security system, touchscreen devices on mobile phone, computing. So NASA uses these sensors in the International Space Station for helping humans with repairing and maintenance in the environment. Then NASA also has trialed many tactile sensors in robotics, which are in the initial stage. That's all from my side. Thank you.